I give glory to the name of the Lord for the opportunity He gave to me on this series 3. And I pray all you listener, the Lord will give you grace to make heaven in Jesus' name. As I was saying in my second series, I'm talking about my assignment in the Christendom. I told you how we started by establishing fake churches because the target of my call is to eradicate the holiness in the church, because we believe that if the holiness continue in the church, if they still remain in the true word of God, we don't deceive them and give them the counterfeit, then they will continue to make heaven. So therefore, that is why we started establishing fake church by calling fake ministers. And apart from churches, we still have some other preparation. We still have some other area we work. For example, our preparation in gospel musician, the way we deceive the choirs, our work in baptism and Holy Communion, how we work among the workers in the church, everything I will explain. So when I want to start my work, if these people, after we have ordained them, finish from the water, we have collected the anointed man of God star for them and an anointed man of God star and spam everything for them, when they come to this world, if they want to start their own church, they don't start in a local way. I'm not telling you that anybody that starts church in a big way is from devil. God can still make you to start in a big way if God wants it that way. But in our own people, we made them to start in a big way at times. Some also start in a terrible, in a rough way, and they are also demon. The only thing is that it depends on the level of demon that is using you. If the level of your demon that is using you is a local level, you can start with poverty. Doesn't mean. So I'm not saying that anybody that start the work of God in poverty is only by God. No. There's no system that devil cannot use. But I'm saying normally in our own system, we normally establish for our people in a better way. So we give them good location. But we have these people I'm talking about, they are trained one. We have already taught them the type of sermon they will be giving. The sermon we teach them, we have trained them for, it's not for salvation. It's just to make, we only train them to teach people that. We teach them to love God. They will know that God is great. They will know that God is good. They will know He's a miracle maker. They will know He do wonders. God can bless them. They will make them to see God as a friend. But they will not allow them to remember or to see God as a God that is seriously annoyed with this world of sin. They will not bring their mind to the destruction that is coming ahead this world. They will, when in their preaching, they will be telling people, don't commit sin. They will not touch the perceived sin the Bible is talking about. They will not emphasize on the common sin of every day. Their preaching will basic on miracle healing. For example, a pastor wants to preach in a month. Maybe they do 3 services in a week. 3 times 4, that is 12. A pastor wants to preach 12 times in a month. Imagine, 12 times in a month, he preaches about miracle, success, breakthrough, power, faith, good. But out of these 3, 12 messages, he find it very difficult to give a topic of holiness, a topic of righteousness. He find it difficult to preach about the fear of God, or even any topic they give, they will still land up with blessing and miracle. Listen, I'm telling you, if you see any pastor preaching like that, know that is one of the agents of darkness. Is either registered agent or ignorant agent. What I mean by ignorant agent is that some people are working for devil. they don't know that it's the devil they are working for. They thought it's God. They did not go to shrine. They did not go to darkness. They did not make covenant. But ignorantly, they are working for devil because their sermon, their system is the same system of darkness. So if you see a pastor in a month preaching about miracle, wonderful, powerful faith, love God, it's good to love God. Jesus Christ also say, love your God. Love your God. If you love God, you will not hunt God. You will not do the thing that will make God to be annoyed. So when we're talking about love God is not only by spending money in the church. Love God is not only by coming to church regularly, but love God means fear God, fear Him, obey His word. When you obey God's commandment, it is then you love God, not by giving money alone. But these people, because of their business, they only preach about what pleasing them, what profits them. That is what they will specify on their preaching. But what I'm saying is this: these are people, we train them to preach about some things around salvation, but this salvation, they will deceive people on the language of salvation. They will teach them that if you have been coming to church, confess the name of Jesus Christ and accept Christ. Truly, Bible say accept Christ. Yes, accept Christ. Come to church, then be regular in the church. Pay your tithes, pay your offering, donate in the church. That is all. They will tell them it's not good to fornicate. They will tell them it's not good to lie. But the reason why we have church is to be repeating that sin every day. The reason why we are coming to church every day is for the pastor to be repeating that thing that will hinder us from making heaven. But what we are repeating every day in our church today is blessing and breakthrough. A pastor that preached about how to become great last week will still become how to become blessed this week. If it is the kingdom of heaven, righteousness, we are repeating like that every day. How do you think Christendom will be today? So you preacher, watch yourself. If you listen to this sermon, if you don't change, the sermon will judge you. If it is God that called you, truly God Almighty called you, I'm not arguing. But if you preach the way others preach, you have already divert, and God will reject you and replace you. Because the reason why He called you, He has something in His mind that He wants to speak out from your mouth. But you forsake the mind of God and you are preaching what others are preaching. Why is it so important for you to imitate somebody preaching? Forget about what others preach. They know what their God sent them. I also preach blessing in my church. I also preach miracle in my church. But maybe once in 3 months or once in a month. And any day I mention it, people are blessed. But my real work, my real assignment is to preach rapture and holiness so that people can make heaven. And any other assignment outside this, beware. The reason why God is raising prophets, pastors, go back to the Bible. God always called people to preach repentance, to warn people. All your Bible, God called them to warn people. So anybody, even Abraham also preached salvation. So life of Abraham preached obedience, total obedience to the Lord. So you cannot just be turning Bible upside down for people. So even though somebody has been deceiving you, after this case, don't be deceived again. After listening to this testimony, don't be deceived again. So these are our people. We have trained them how to eradicate the fear of God from the heart of people. We told them to teach people that God is good, God is love, God is that. But the fear of death and the fear of hellfire, we don't remember them always. And human being, it is when something continues repeating in their head, they remember. Some churches, throughout a year, they will not treat revelation. And any church that want the member to be alive in Christ, they must be treating revelation every year. So let them know what is coming upon them if they refuse to live holy life. Church is not an entertainment hall. Why should member be clapping for you every day when you are preaching? If member continue clapping for you every day, that means you are out of the ray. You must preach to them. There was a day Jesus Christ tells the people the truth. They go away from him. You are afraid to lose member, but you don't care if people lose heaven. God is losing souls every day, and you are gaining one soul in your church. Your church is full, but heaven is reducing. God has been disappointed in you. If truly you are working for God, you must care about souls, salvation, not population. God doesn't care for your population, but God care for salvation. So these are the way to know those fake ministers and genuine one, if you want to know. And not only this, our people in the kingdom of darkness that we choose, they also do miracle, because we give them power for miracle. See all those holy church, in their church they will preach holiness, they will preach salvation, people will have the true word of God, but problem will be accumulated in their life. They will pray, there will be no answer. The reason why they did not answer, not that God doesn't answer their prayer, but we have set monitoring demon and standby demon to be reporting them, to be accusing them of their prayer. They'll be, God, your words say no sinner shall go unpunished, though this brother deserve this blessing, but because he has committed this sin, that is why he must be punished according to your word. Because the book of Deuteronomy 28 verse 47, Deuteronomy 28 verse 47, he said in that passage that because you did not serve the Lord your God joyfully and gladly in the time of prosperity, therefore in hunger and tasting, in nakedness and dear poverty, you will serve the enemy the Lord sent against you. He will put an iron yoke on your neck until he has destroyed you. So they will remember that God has promised that he will hand them over to the enemy. So therefore, God has handed them over to the demons, so that demons will punish them. So this quotation has been hindering them from receiving blessing. And the worst part is that when the faithful ones pray and receive blessing from God, God will send angel to bring the blessing. But when the angel gets to the church, the same thing that happened to the angel of Daniel and Daniel will happen to those angels. They will hijack them. And when they hijack them, they will now seize the blessing. So they will still be expecting blessing from God, whereas God has released the blessing. But the little sin we don't count, make backbiting, rebellion, or maybe lies or laziness, maybe somebody failed to do what he's supposed to do in the church, maybe you are not faithful to your tithe, maybe you are not faithful to your, you do not pay especially vow and tithe, or you lie, or you commit adultery, anything, or you pretend, things like this. This enemy can, they will use it. They know God is faithful to his word. He will not deny his word. Even though the angel want to fight, they will tell the angel that God is not a respecter of anybody. If even an earth pass away, the word of God must come, must be fulfilled. So the angel will be silenced, he will not be able to do anything, and they will seize the blessing. So people now think that all those holy church at times, testimony is not rampant there, the big miracle is not happening there, because the accuser is too much on them. But these fake churches, I'm not telling you that any church that it does much miracle is of devil. Don't misquote me. But I'm just telling you ways, the way to detect them. If you see any church, they are doing miracle, mighty miracle, and sin aborted there, they dress like Jezebel, and God refused to warn them about that. God refused to mention their mistakes to them, and he's still blessing them. I'm sure it's not God. If it is God that is doing miracle, God must tell them things that will not make them, because the business of God is not miracle. The business of God in a church is salvation. Miracle is just invitation to give them faith. Miracle is not the business. The business of God is salvation. Miracle is just to build our faith so that we can listen to what God wants. But church today, they capitalize on miracle. If it's all about miracle, then how will God be blessed? How will God gain from his business? God has invests on gospel, but gospel is bringing no gain. So please, nobody can deceive you unless if you deceive yourself. So in these churches, the faithful ones, they will pray, they will follow the word, but testimony is not coming forth because we are accusing them. But you see all these fake ones, nobody is accusing them. Apart from that, the God, they are served. The power that released miracle unto them, the heavenly array, the queen of heaven doesn't count on their sin. That is why you see some pastor, they will preach in their church. They will say, blood of Jesus Christ is there. Anytime you commit sin, go and plead the blood. He will remove your sin and you get whatever you have from God. Listen, blood of Jesus Christ is not for habitual sinner. Blood of Jesus Christ is for a sinner that repents. When you repent, you forsake, the blood will cancel the record, then God will see you as a holy man. Then you will be adopted into the kingdom of God as a child of God. But know that he forgive you today, you go back as a bastard. Tomorrow you plead the blood again, you come back as a son. Tomorrow you go back as a bastard. No, God is not a baby. Don't you know how many years it took God to test Abraham before he can call him a friend? So because we have grace, must we abuse the grace? No. So if your pastor told you that blood just is dear for you to commit sin and bath like a bathroom water, it's not like that. He said if anybody tested the grace of God and go back into sin, he said the person did not deserve heaven. So you don't need to be falling and rise every day. If you see any pastor preaching to you that anytime you commit sin, just go and take the blood, that means that anytime you fornicate, if you fornicate 3 times in a week, remember to plead the blood of Jesus Christ. That's the meaning of that. And that's not what the Bible says. Bible says, be holy as your Father in heaven is holy. That means God means that we can be holy. I'm not telling you that we can holy like God. But let me tell you something. You can still be holy if Paul can still make it. Formerly he say, I'm trying, but the flesh did not allow me. But later he say, I have already gotten it. If God can enable him to gotten it and make heaven, if Stephen can make heaven, we are also making. Is it not the same crown those people get we are also pursuing? Is it not the same score mark? If it's the same score mark, let me tell you something. You cannot be living a life of sin and you go and collect the same crown those people collect. God is not a partial God. You must be holy as the old one. Old time believer. If you don't do it like the old one, you cannot get what they get. If it's the same thing the old one gets, you are pursuing. That means you must be like the old. You must go back to the old time believer. All this modern Christian you are doing, let me tell you something. God is not there. What I'm saying is this. The faithful ones in the church, they will now be seeing all those counterfeits prospering, miracle all the times, giant miracle. God also did it, but the people in the spirit, the demons, they hijack it by reporting us of our little sins. But those people, they have their own because nobody is accusing them, because their own God doesn't catch all those little sins. What we people in the church believe today is just miracle. What is behind miracle? Better clear to know the power behind your miracle you receive, or else you regret after receiving. So it's better not to regret after receiving. And anything that devil give you, devil is not a fool, he's wiser than you. It's only the Spirit of God that makes you wiser than him. So please, whatever devil gives to you, you must pay for it. either now or eternity. So don't think you can just go into the devil and take something from devil and come back and praise God here. No. Whatever I give to you, some demons must follow you and live your life with you together with that miracle. So you can still repent now, pray for forgiveness now, go back to your God and live an holy life. Holy life is the only access to heaven. Without holiness, you cannot make heaven. Bible talk about Lazarus that been raised from death. Truly, Lazarus is raised from dead. Yes, that is miracle. But Bible did not prove to us that he make heaven. Until when we get heaven, we know that. So that one is miracle. But when we are talking about salvation, Jesus Christ preached salvation. But he does miracle. He does miracle and preach salvation. So miracle is invitation. Salvation is the profit of God. So when we're talking about church business, you know those who are in business and you know those who are being sent by God. You must differentiate it. May God bless you as you listen to this message. So that is how we do our churches in that is area of church. I'm still coming back to that. But in the area of model, I specific on that. When I want to start my work on model, because in the fake churches, we allow them to dress so that they can make use of the materials we want to produce for them. And in these counterfeit churches, they don't care about how women dress in the church. For example, in my Bible told me in the book of Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 6, he said, if a woman does not cover her head, she should have her hair cut off. And if it's a disgrace for a woman to have her hair cut off or shaved off, she should cover her head. And you now go forward in verse 13. He said, judge. I'm reading an NIV. He said, judge for yourself. Imagine when you hear judge, you to consider now. That means he's so serious in what he's saying. He's expecting our understanding to open. When he says judge for yourself, Paul means that we ourselves are supposed to know. He doesn't even need to tell ourselves. Judge yourself. Is it proper for a woman to pray to God with her head uncovered? But this counterfeit church, this is what they prove. They prove verse 15. But that if a woman has long hair, it is her glory. For long hair is given to her as a covering hair. Means that your long hair is your glory, is your beauty, to cover your scalp. But this verse 13 is talking about when you want to pray, when you want to talk to God, not when you are going around the street. He's talking about when you want to talk to God. But the worst part in the church today, they do not even have this long hair. Maybe the Oyibo have, the white men have long hair. But we black, we don't even have this long hair. What we use is long attachment. And you will see, people will use attachment, palming in the church, praising God, and God will be doing miracle. God will never even open only one person's eyes to see that God is anointed. I wonder why. I wonder why. So, your church doctrine may change, but the Bible will not change. Your system may change, Bible will not change. Bible says you should cover your head when praying to God, not talking to your husband now, God Almighty. And the Bible says that if you cannot cover your head, shave it off. If it will be a disgrace to you, then cover it. Is it not enough? You now cancel all those one. You now click on verse 15. But mind you, either you believe in me or not, those are the things we train our pastor in the kingdom of darkness. So those are the key points we give them to deceive people in the world. So if you are one of the pastor holding on this thing, even though devil did not call you, you have joined those that are being called by devil. Better go back to your God. Say the truth. Don't be afraid to lose member. Don't be afraid. Don't you know how many people that go away from Jesus? Did that stop the gospel of Jesus Christ? Rather he continue. If the children of devil come to you, they will go when they hear the truth. When the real children of God come, the truth word of God will tie them down. But sha, I'm not surprised. Not all pastors are in the business of God. Many are in the business of their pockets. So in the church, women has been using as a powerful weapon for darkness to destroy churches. So in that, our counterfeit church, these are the system we use so that to divide the attention of the holy ones. With all their holiness, there'll be no miracle. Those people, they dress like Jezebel, they see miracle, and the holy one are confused. They don't know which one is the right. Those things we say is his sin. Still, God is not counting. Then if God is no more counting our dressing, then let's dress how we like. That is what we did in the church. So nobody can prove that the way we dress is better, because you that you think you are better, still you are suffering. And those people you condemn, they receive miracle every day so that everybody are convinced. That is how we did it. I'm the person that carried the assignment. So please, if you are under that bondage, lose yourself before you die. Your blood is no more on me. I am free by the grace of God. So if you are under that deceit, your blood will never be counted on me. So this is how I start my operation in model line. I go to, according to my proposal quotation, Romans 1:26. We are talking about artificial. And I'll go to Queen of the Coast. I want to give Africa artificial beauty. So he now took me to the lab and say, and I told them I want to start from here. They now give me idea to introduce threshing comb. You know, we African, we have a coil here. So threshing comb will now turn into straight ear. So from coil to straight, that means it's not natural anymore. It has turned to artificial. So when I introduced that, people use it. And later, they started complaining that hair started cutting. They don't have long hair. I go back to Queen of the Coast. He now told me that, okay, he will give me another idea. They took me to lab. We do relaxer. You can tell me that cosmetics. It's ordinary cosmetics so that we use to relax that. Whatever you like, even though we can use ordinary sand, it is the covenant behind it that is important. When we go to the lab, he now produce relaxer for me. And I say, give this thing to them. When they use it for their hair will change from coil to long to straight one. And it will make their hair not to be natural anymore. So far, it's not natural. If they die with it, this quotation you quote, we condemn them. And we all rejoice. We hey, they clap for me. And that is how we came to the world. And we started producing relaxer. If you remember, there's some relaxer called ostrachin, some others, old relaxer. Don't let me mention. But the idea of relaxer comes from the Queen of the Coast. She's the one that gave me the idea. And we started producing it. And later, when this started spreading, people using it, still some people still come up complaining that their hair is not long very well. So I go back to Queen of the Coast. She now told me that the only way he can assist me is to send me to another person that specific his kingdom on beauty. He said there was a woman, the most beautiful woman in the whole world, that being cursed and she has turned to beast. I should go to her temple. If you are one of the people that watched this film called Clash of the Titan, this film called Clash of the Titan, you will see that film. There's a temple that strong man go to cut somebody, to cut one idol head. That the head of that idol is full of snake. So that person, they send that man to go and cut his head. It was the eyes of that idol that have power. So it was the eyes of that idol they want to use in that film. So that person they sent me to go and meet, just like that thing that head they caught in Clash of the Titan. That is just how the person, the personality look like. When I get there, she welcomed me and I asked me what do I want. And I told her that I'm here to collect artificial beauty for my people. And I'll say, okay, no problem. He now say, he will give me. He now bring out a cup filled with blood and they turn into mercury or something like that, or chemical. All these things called chemical you are mentioning. If you know the meaning of chemical, do you think that all chemical is being produced in a factory? And mind you, even though all chemical is being produced in a factory, do you think all these factories on Earth? We have many factories in the deep sea producing many products you are buying in the market. If you just call chemical, did you know the source of all this chemical? So not all chemical you can talk about. So he just gave me the chemical, and he told me that when we just get this word, we can use ordinary rubber, we refine the chemical with it and it turn to attachment. So you may say, you are a cosmetic in this thing and you know how they produce attachment. Yes, you may know how they produce it. Is it not ordinary chemical you mix together with some rubber and turn to attachment? Yes, but the covenant behind the chemical will speak after death. The covenant we make together with that beast is that the beast told me that anybody that use this chemical, what they produce from this chemical, the person, and if he use the beauty, after his death, his appearance and head would turn to what he is. That means after death, anybody using attachment, his ear will turn to snake. And I'm sure snake can never enter into the kingdom of God, according to Revelation 21:27. So therefore, he now told me that that's a covenant. Go and give to them. But you know, in our kingdom, we don't give anything for free. So the reward of it is that after using this beauty on earth, immediately after you die, your image will look my like, and all their hair will turn to snake, and I agree with him, and we sign the paper. Then they give me the chemical. Then that's how we started producing the chemical, and people are using it. They will use it. They produce chemical. So you can mention any type of name of chemical. But what I'm telling you is that be careful. You are in the world, you don't know how it started. So that is what all about attachment. So if you say you are using attachment, you say you want to bless it by the name of Jesus Christ, okay, you can go ahead, but I know Jesus Christ will never take what does not belong to him from you. So that is why you must do away from artificial. Remain natural. It is your natural being that will make heaven, not the one that is not natural. So therefore, this attachment and palming, I'm the author of it. And now I'm telling you that I'm out of it. So if you are there using it, your blood is on you. Let me even tell you something about women for the last day. Did you remember that formerly women in the whole world are glorious? But it is this our dressing that we are dressing. That even caused God to curse all the women for the last day. If you remember the book of Isaiah chapter 3, you will see how God cursed women. Not because of killing or maybe because they are worshipping idol, but God cursed women because of their dressing. He cursed women. Listen, let me read from Isaiah chapter 3 verse 16. He said, the Lord said, the women of Zion are only walking along with outstretching neck, flitting with their ear, tripping along with missing step, with ornaments jingling on their ankle. That is ankle chain. Therefore, the Lord will bring sore on their head of the women of Zion. The Lord will make their scalp bow. And you always prove that you're a daughter of Zion. If truly you are a daughter of Zion, you are a child of God. And if you are using all these things I'm going to mention here, the curse of God is upon you. In that day, the Lord will snatch away their fairing and the baglings and headband and crimson necklace, the earrings and bracelets and veil, the head dresses and ankle chain and sash, the perfume bottle and charms, the signet ring and nose ring, the fine robes and the carpets, and clock and the pulse and the, you see, let me tell you something. All these things they mention here, go back and read it. Exactly what caused God to curse women for the last day in the book of Isaiah chapter 3. That is exactly what's going on in the church today. That is why you see women, they say they don't have husband, they don't have husband. Why should they have husband? Did you forget chapter 4 verse 1? He say, in that day, seven women will take hold of one man and say, we will eat our own food and provide our own clothes. Only let us be called by your name. Take away our disgrace. And later you say it is witch and wizard. It is spiritual husband. It is this and that. Who brought spiritual husband? All these things brought spiritual husband on you. The anger of God brought spiritual husband. The anger of God give power to the ancestral demon. The anger of God give power to the witches and wizard. God is there looking at you. See them punishing you. He's silent because he knows that you are under the chain of sin. It is curse of God, the anger of God that bring those people to rule you. Even though you call the name of Jesus Christ and stand, they did not feel their power because you are under the anger of God. Unless you come out from the anger of God, then your prayer will be answered. Even though you are using all these things, still you can marry, you can have children. But what about hellfire? So, if women on earth refuse to change, God is not a baby. God is still God. God can never come down to our level. We are the people that will go to the level of God. Praise the Lord. Let me tell you, some people can say that even though if it's not good to use earring, why are we putting hole in our hair? Do you know the meaning of putting hole? In the land of Israel, it is slave that used to put hole in their hair. Let me read it for you. Deuteronomy chapter 15, I read from verse 16. But if your servant say to you, I do not want to leave you because he loves you and your family and he is well off with you, verse 17, then take an owi and push it through his ear, loop into the door, and he will become your servant for life. Do the same for your maid servant. Imagine, if you want to be a servant for life, and you know that heaven is for the children of God, it's for the sons and daughters of Zion, it's not for the slave. So if you want to be a slave for life, you can continue putting earring. Even though you have making hole before, God can still forgive you if you stop putting something there. But some people, they will still born child and continue putting hole, means they are slave together with their children. If you continue putting hole in your ear, this quotation of the Bible is talking about you. So that is why you need to be very careful. Be a good Bible reader so that Bible will not stand against you in the day of judgment. So these are the things that bring the anger of God upon women and still we refuse to listen. Those so-called pastors you follow up and down, ask them, don't they see this thing in their Bible? Or they believe it's Old Testament? If God can condemn it in Old Testament, I'm sure New Testament is still the same. Jesus Christ said, I did not come to condemn the old, but to fulfill it. So Jesus Christ did not condemn the Old Testament. The only thing Jesus Christ condemned is the curse that God gave us in the Garden of Eden. So that he said, the curse said we shall die. And Jesus Christ bring life. It is life he brought. He does not eradicate the law. He said, put it in your heart. Let it be in your heart. Meditating in it day and night. Holy Spirit is not making mistake by combining Old Testament and New Testament in the same book. It's not a mistake. So please, don't allow the theologians to mislead you by saying promise of God is different. It's not different. God is saying the same thing. Concerning those people that make up, let me tell you something. Did you know that the first woman that make up in the Bible is Jezebel? The first woman that make up in the Bible is Jezebel. That is your mother, your grandmother. If you always make up, your grandmother is Jezebel. And you will end up where Jezebel end up, unless you repent. Let me read 2 Kings chapter 9, verse 30 says, then Jehu went to Jezreel. When Jezebel heard about it, she painted her eyes, arranged her hair, and looked out of a window. Imagine, he want to seduce the man. She's the go through your Bible. She's the first woman that make up in the Bible. So if Jezebel is the first woman that make up, Sarah did not make up. Elizabeth did not make up. Bible did not tell us that they want to go to Shiloh and they make up. It is Jezebel that is the first woman that make up in the Bible. So you are in line of Jezebel. There must be difference between Delilah and Deborah. You cannot dress like a Delilah and prove you are a Deborah. No, you can deceive yourself. You cannot deceive God. So please and please, the reason why I'm repeating this, because I know many has gone to hell because of this, and I don't want you to join them in hell. This case may be a salvation for your soul if you accept it, not by force. I'm not forcing anybody to follow it, but if you accept it, if you take it, then it will turn to life in your life in Jesus' name. So, as I was saying, this is how we produce attachment and palming to condemn people to hellfire. We know all these things, all these ornaments, all these dressings, God did not like it. For example, let's talk about trousers in the church. Women, ladies wearing trousers in the church. Some people, there was a day I turned on my television and I saw a woman of God, Pastor Mrs. I will not mention her name. On Sunday morning, I was going to church. The Spirit said, I should on my television. I say, I reject, I rebuke. How can I on television on Sunday morning? The Spirit said, on it, I want to show you something. As I on it, I saw a pastor, Mrs. being interviewed on the television. And the person that interviewed her say, Madam, please, some Christians say it's not good for a woman to wear trousers. What do you see to that? She now replied and say, the Bible says, my people die for lack of knowledge. Don't mind them. They don't know that there's difference between men trousers and women trousers. We have lady trousers and men trousers. If you don't wear men trousers, if you wear lady trousers, it's not a sin. And let me tell you something, that statement is a lie. There's nothing like men trousers or lady trousers. I'm the one that designed lady trousers in the kingdom of darkness after our meeting. Because we read the Bible in Deuteronomy 22, verse 5. He said, a woman must not wear men clothes, nor a man wear women clothes, for the Lord your God detests anyone who does this. You see, when God say I hate it, can you force God to love it? He said I hate it. And God have said it once. He has said it once. The next thing he's going to say about it is judgment. So you cannot force God to love what you want. God is God. He cannot come to your level. You are the one that will go to the level of God. God will never come down to your level because he loves you. So that is why you must read the Bible very well before you die. If you follow what one pastor say, you don't follow what Bible say, you are killing yourself. Bible hates it. Somebody asked me a question and say, madam, you know, I'm a Igbo woman. And in our culture, man normally puts wrapper. And I ask her, your culture, is your culture designed by God, African demons? All our culture in Africa here, it's our demon that designed it for us. The way we do things. Our culture, it's our demon that designed most of it. So, if you say men wear tie wrapper, does that mean that it's biblical? So far you know that wrapper is always made for women. Then stay away from it. So please, forget about your culture or this. Let Bible be your culture. Some people told me that it is the culture of the white women to be wearing trousers. And I proved to them that it's a lie. Go to the ancient film. The Europe, all those people, Asia countries. You see them, their women put on gown, big gown. The gathers will be full like umbrella, like a wedding gown. They will put stocking. They will put glove in their hand and small hat on their head. That is their own culture. That is the style of their dress, not trouser. It is later in the modern day you see women wearing trouser, so that you cannot deceive yourself. God knows the beginning of the world. Which day are you born? You cannot tell God the story of this world. God knows the beginning of everything. So please, even though you don't believe me, believe the word of God. So this is the reason why we brought all these dresses into the church. To my surprise today, we see a lady evangelist putting on trouser, attachment, makeup, dress exactly like Delilah. In fact, half of their breast outside. Half of their breast. The reason why we design half naked dressing is because we want our agent to seduce men. So if you wear the cloth being designed for agents and you say you are a child of God, that means you have changed, because things, you must not dress in common with them. Some people will wear long skirts and they will now tear that skirt to the lap. It's still the same thing. The skirt is not long, so far it's been tear. Is it open to your lap? So therefore, if you want to be in, remain in. If you want to be out, remain out. You cannot be between the in and out. That means heaven is going to pour you out. And I pray heaven will not pour you out in Jesus' name. So therefore, be very, very careful. If you want to live for the kingdom, live for the kingdom. If you want to be against the kingdom, stand against the kingdom. Then you face your judgment. So please, if you say you don't know which way to go, this testimony is giving you which way to go. I'm not the only one saying this. Go out, you see many people. Not only the people that come out from the kingdom of darkness that are saying this. Many people that God speaks to in the dream. Many people go in trance. Some people will die 2 days and come back and say this. So I'm not the only one saying it. If you don't believe me, what about the people that are not in darkness before? They go to heaven and come back. They die 3 days and wake up. Some die 2 and 4 hours and wake up. What about them? Don't you believe them also? Or you are expecting Jesus Christ to fall down and preach to you again? So that is why I'm beseeching you to follow the word of God. And not only that, concerning these worldly dressings in the church, we have used this thing to destroy many saints. See, in hellfire, don't you know that we have saints in hellfire? Because all those things they believe is true, they follow it, but those ones they did not believe kills them. Some did not fornicate, some did not steal, some did not, they are not winch, but the little things I'm talking about, because they are ignorant of it. That is why the Bible says my people die for the lack of understanding. So if you quote that quotation is talking about what I'm saying now, because you lack to understand what I'm saying. And that is what Holy Spirit is supposed to reveal to you. That's why you must have Holy Spirit. Even though nobody teach you, Holy Spirit can show you in your dream. Many people that have Holy Spirit, many people, Holy Spirit has showed them. It's a mystery. It is from Holy Spirit you can get wisdom and mystery. So Holy Spirit is the wisdom. And the wisdom in Holy Spirit is by showing you, revealing things, mystery. So if you don't have Holy Spirit, you don't have wisdom. And if you don't have wisdom, you will not be wiser than devil. So those are the areas that Holy Spirit work. The major work of Holy Spirit is to inform you the things that will never allow you to make heaven. The major work of Holy Spirit is to guide you to heaven. So that Holy Spirit you have that only does miracle, that Holy Spirit you are that only speak in tongue, but that does not hint you the thing that will block you for heaven, that is a counterfeit Holy Spirit. Genuine Holy Spirit, the major work he must do is to guide you to heaven, not only to be doing miracle every day. And not only that, these our counterfeit churches and ministers, we have programmed the hand of so-called fake minister. We've computerized their hand or put black glove. anybody that took the river for holy for baptism, the moment they dip you into the river, they have dedicated you into the marine kingdom, into the hand of the queen of the coast. So by doing baptism, you can also be initiated, because their hand has been programmed for initiation. So they have connected you to the queen of the coast. So that is why if you go to their church, you anything can happen to your life. Not only that, their holy communion, as they give you holy communion, truly you may be the one that buy the wine by yourself, but their hand has been programmed. Laying hand on you can even initiate you, because their hand has been programmed their own initiation is very, very strong. Giving you holy communion, that blood they gave to you is not the blood of Jesus Christ. They gave you the blood of the darkness, the blood of the Antichrist. They give you the flesh of the Antichrist. So that is why you need to be very, very careful. If you go there for their miracle, you go there for initiation. Be careful. Remain in holiness. Let me tell you something. Devil is not a fool. Devil give as he take. That is how he give. So be very, very careful. I'm not telling you one name of one pastor, one is good, one is bad. I myself, I can't prove anybody to you. But what I'm saying is this. It is only by the genuine spirit of God in you that will decide the right one for you. So please, if truly you want to go to heaven, immediately when you receive Christ, the first thing to target is genuine Holy Spirit. If you don't target the genuine Holy Spirit, there are deceivers on the way. They will deceive. Even in the church, you'll be deceived. You can be deceived anywhere. But the Holy Spirit will come gentle and tell you the real one if you are still obedient. So please, by Holy Communion, many people got initiated. Even though in the church, when they do anniversary, what they do, convention, they know people will cook. And from there, some of our agents will join those people that will cook. If maybe they will buy cow in the church, they will go there when they tie the cow. Before they break, they will throw the cow to human being. Maybe there's one child of God, saint that they be inflicted in their meeting. They want to kill the angel of God, not allow them to kill. The person is on sickness for past 3 months. When they want to kill that person and the angel of God not allow them to kill the person in their meeting, they will now bring that person to the church, turn it to cow. In the following day, the children of God will kill that person by themselves, and they will all eat the flesh of the saints, and the anger of God will be upon all the church members. They will eat the flesh of human beings, and they will all go initiated in the kingdom of darkness in one way or the other. That is why I plead unto you, pastors, if you want to do any anniversary convention in your church, whatever they buy, have time, pray over it, sanctify by the blood of Jesus Christ, so that the plan of devil and darkness on him may be cancelled, so that people will not get initiated in the church. Not only the church, they initiate many people from the hospital, from the school, university, nursery, primary, secondary, even in the bank. So when we get to series 4, I'll see tell you some of this. I'm sorry for taking much of your time. I just need to explain it in total so that you can get me right. And I pray, as you really want to make heaven, God will give you and enable you to follow the true word of God. And God will give you easy mind, flexible mind, mind of flesh, to be controlled by the Holy Spirit, and devil will never have part in your life in Jesus' name. God bless you as you go along with me to series 4.